Every day, we watch programs on the television and listen to programs on the radio or music on the tape recorder. These programs, which we enjoy, are either visual or audio programs. Video programs, which we see, are a combination of visuals and audio, like music, songs, speech, and so on. Audio programs which we hear are songs, speech, full screen dialogue, music, and so on. These are without visuals. When we watch programs on the television, we understand the conversation, the music, and songs with the help of the audio. And if we fade out the audio, we may not completely be able to understand what the program has to say. Thus, the audio totally supports the video and helps us to get the complete effect of its performance. Audio programs also help us to pass time at home or during travel. In this program, we will tell you how audio recording is done for television and other programs. Since olden days, audio recording is done in the audio magnetic tape, and this is continuing till today. In the early period of audio programs, the audio was transferred to plastic discs and played on record players and gramophones. Later, the magnetic tape itself was played on record players. The ATR had a slow development from large spools through tape recorders, mini tape recorders, Walkman with recording equipment, pocket recorders, to the professional ATR. Now, the entire system of audio recording has reached the peak of its development in the form of the compact disc, commonly called CD. This is a recorded compact disc and is meant only for playing. This compact disc is meant for recording. But the present system of audio recording is the audio tape recorder. Let's now see the external features, essential parts, and functions of the ATR. The ATR consists of the body or deck, the headstack assembly, the guides for the tape, the take-off and take-up spools, the spindles for the spools, the audio panel, the time code control panel, the transport control panel, and the alignment control panel. Now you can see the connector panel on the back side of the ATR. It consists of the audio input for channel 1, channel 2, and channel 3, the audio output for channel 1, channel 2, and channel 3, time code input and time code output. Let us now see each part one by one. The body or deck of the ATR consists of the entire package of electronics which control its function, and it is also called the electronic assembly. The head stack consists of the timecode head, which is used for timing, the erase head, which is used for erasing the program recorded in the selected channel, the sync or record head, which is used for recording the program in the selected channel, and the reproduction head, which is used for playing or reproducing the program for review. Guides, which deliver the tape smoothly from the takeoff to the take-up spool. The transport control panel. It consists of rewind, forward, play, stop, record, and edit keys. The other keys are for speed, time display, reset, and search mode for rewind or forward. The transport control panel plays an important role by transporting or running the tape and commanding the particular function by pressing a particular key. Alignment control panel. Located on the front of the deck, the function of alignment control is electronic adjustment of the audio amplifiers and equalization circuiting to conform to specifications. It consists of reproduction, sync, control, input, etc. Audio control panel. This panel has the audio level meter, VU, and the keys for selection of function either for recording or playing. Here it is paneled for two channels, channel 1 and channel 2. Time code control panel. The function of this panel is to control the time display. Additionally, here the speaker for audio out is attached. The keys below the meter are to be selected for the reproduction of audio from either channel 1 or channel 2. For controlling the output audio level, we can tune this knob for low or high. Let's now come to the operation and function of the ATR. During music or speech recording, the microphone is placed in front of the musician or presenter. The tape in which the audio program is to be recorded is already wound in the spool. This spool is clamped with the spindle of the ATR, which runs forward to deliver the tape. The spool which is clamped at the place of delivery end is called takeoff spool. The lead of the audio tape is brought to the head stack through guides. The tape is threaded on the heads of the head stack. Again, the lead is taken through the other sides of guide, and lastly, it is wound in the other spool which receives the tape. The spool on received end is called take-up spool. Now, the ATR has to be switched on for power. The time has to be set for recording. The time is shown in the display panel and is to be reset for zero with the help of the reset key. The speed is also to be set with the help of the speed key. Then the channel is to be selected, either channel 1 or channel 2. The audio level is adjusted by winding the knob of the audio control, by which we can observe or increase or decrease the audio level in the VU meter. The audio signal, either from the audio mixer or directly from the microphone, is to be given through the connector panel to the selected channel, either channel 1 or channel 2. The audio out is to be given to the external monitor if necessary. The audio level is to be checked by a rehearsal of the program. Now, the ATR is ready for recording. On a cue from the music director, presenter, or producer, the tape is rolled by pressing the play and record keys or the record key only. An audio program is recorded in the recording theater or audio studio. The audio studio or recording theater consists of a performer's cabin, an audio control panel, audio mixer, and recorder. The performer's cabin has the facility of a microphone and seating arrangements for singers or players of musical instruments. The audio control panel has the audio equalizer and mixer. The recording panel has the recorder with spool tapes. For example, in music recording, the performer's cabin is connected to the equalizer and mixer through cables from various sources like the guitar, tabla, synthesizer, etc. The sources come from the performer's cabin, reach the equalizer to balance a particular equipment's music level, and the mixer mixes the audio as single, double, or triple sources like voice, music, special effect sound, etc. The mixed source of audio reaches the recording panel and is recorded in the tape, either in channel 1 or channel 2 or in both.
At the start, beat 7, take 1.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Thus, the tape runs for some time and the recording is done. Again, this procedure can be followed for further recording. After the program is recorded, it can be checked for its quality by pressing the rewind key, the stop key, and playing again. Thus, an audio program is recorded in the recording theater or audio studio. The recorded program is now transferred to audio cassettes, which are to be marketed. Otherwise, the recorded program can be erased by recording another program in the same tape. The original tape which contains the recorded program is known as the master tape. In audio recording, the sound engineer and sound recordist play a vital role. The sound engineer produces good sound quality by adjusting the knobs of equalizer or sound mixer. The function of sound engineering is to equalize or balance the multi-source audio signals and produce an audio program of good quality. The sound recordist determines the best quality signals and operating VTR. So far, you have seen the various formats of audio recording and the various equipments used for audio recording. Lastly, you have seen the various operations and the simple handling method. We hope, viewers, that this program has helped you in getting a basic insight into audio recording and the role it plays in the making of audio programs. Thank you.